guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Meg and I talk about conscious consumerism and the secondhand market. So if that's something that you're interested in, please stay tuned. So today I wanted to talk about my top five mistakes that I've made when I started out thrifting or going through the secondhand market. And when I talk about secondhand market, I'm not just talking about charity shops, op shops, or the thrift shops. I'm also talking about eBay, the Facebook marketplace, Depop, and all that stuff. Okay, everywhere that you can find pre-loved items. Okay, so I want to talk about my first mistake, which was one, buying because it's cheap. Okay, and I think a lot of us thrifters are guilty of this, that we buy things because they're $2, they're $5, they're so cheap that you're like, oh, I'm not really spending that much money, you know, it's not really a big deal if I buy this and I don't end up loving it because, you know, at least I'm saving it from going into the landfills. That was one of my excuses when I started out thrifting, and I ended up accumulating so many things, so many clothes, so many bags, so many shoes that I don't end up using because I'm not really in love with them or they're not my style. But because they were cheap, I was like, oh, like I remember going into one of these op shops and they had t-shirts you can buy $3, $4, $7, and I'm like, take the t-shirts. And then I get home and one, the t-shirt doesn't fit or fits awfully. Second, it's not my style. I don't know where or when I'm ever going to wear that t-shirt. And just because, like, especially like when I go to like Vinny's or Salvo's and they have that rack that has got like a $2 rack, I'm like, oh, I'll try and get as many as I can even though I don't need it and I'm not gonna wear it. Buying things because they're cheap or they're on sale doesn't actually save you money. You're still spending money that you don't need to spend. Okay, so just remember that. Okay, remember that when you're out shopping, ask yourself the question, do I need it? Am I gonna wear it? And how often am I gonna wear it? Okay, so yeah, so that's the first, I would say that's the first mistake. Rookie mistake that I made when I started out thrifting was just like really looking at the price, not the quality of the item, not the material that is used, not the fit, but really just the price. Oh, it's cheap, I'll take it. Right. Second mistake that I have since been making is buying things because of their label. Because they're branded, they're designer. Like Vinny's and Salvo's here in Australia often have a designer rack. Okay, I think the Red Cross one also has it. Like they have like whatever donations they receive that are of designer brands, they have it in a special rack. And I go there and I buy stuff, $25, $50, $75, $100, okay? Because they're branded, because they're designer brands, not necessarily because I need it. Like I've gotten a pair of diesel jeans that doesn't fit me, doesn't look right on eBay, and I bought it because it was diesel, and plus I think that it was being sold new without tags for something like $40 or something, okay? And diesel jeans cost like $200 a pop, okay? I've bought quite a few things like Ralph Lauren, DKNY, Armani, that I bought because it's cheap, but I can't wear because they don't fit well, they're not my style, whatever else the reason. I've got a shit ton of bags that are designer and I bought because they're designer, but like I've got You know those satchel bags that's got like the two handles and then the long strap? I've got how many of those? I think I've got four or five of the same design. Not the same color, but the same design. And how many do I actually need of that? Crossbody bags. How many crossbody bags do I need? Yeah, so buying because of the label, okay, is the second mistake that I have made. Okay, third mistake is not trying on the clothes at the store and then just buying them. Like I look at the label, oh, it says Australia size 10, or it's a size 10, not realizing that size 10 in America is like size 14 here. So I've bought quite a few clothing that says 10 on it, but it's actually an American brand, so therefore it's American sizing and doesn't fit me, they're too big. Or clothes that are too small. I bought a dress from Dorothy Perkins, which is labeled as Australia 10, but I didn't realize it was petite, so it was too short on me. Like my bum was about to show. And this is supposed to be a dress, not a t-shirt. And I also, like just seeing size 10, but not realizing that this is vintage clothing, therefore vintage sizing, and vintage sizing is often smaller than the current modern sizing. So I see a 10, but it's actually more like an 8 now. And because I didn't try it on, I bring it home, doesn't fit me, what happens? I just spent, even though let's say it's $10 or $15 or $20, that still accumulates, and after a while that $10, $15, $20 becomes hundreds of dollars. And if you're not going to use it and it ends up going back into the charity shops, you might as well just give your money directly to the charity shop. Okay, so that's the third mistake that I have made, is not trying them on, or like trying them on, because I remember buying my and other stories white pair of jeans. I tried them on, it was a size 30. I usually wear a 28. Okay, it was a size 30. It was still quite snug, especially around, because it's high-rise jeans, and everybody was all over this high-rise mom jeans, and I was like, I want a high-rise mom jeans, but I need to understand that the shape of my body is mom jeans is not flattering. I've already got a short torso naturally, and if I wear mom jeans, I feel like I don't have a torso. It's like boobs and then hips. That's it. So, yeah. So that's number three, is not trying on the clothing, or trying it on and still convincing yourself that it looks good on you just because it's on trend. Actually, that's the fourth thing that I want to talk about, is buying something that's on trend. Okay, what I've done since discovering the secondhand market is subscribing to several thrifting channels on YouTube, and obviously they talk about thrifting, the trends, like the end of the season, and I'm like, oh, I want to buy that. But the thing is, I'm a very basic person. I'm a basic biatch. I live in t-shirts and jeans, t-shirts and shorts. I sometimes wear skirts. Even rarer would be dresses, and I found myself buying dresses that I don't think I will ever wear. I've got one vintage dress that I got from the Surrey Hills Vintage Market, and it's beautiful, and it looks cute, and it's really vintage, but it's not me. So it's hanging in my closet. I haven't worn it out, and it's been there for 2 months now. So, yeah, just like thrifting the trends, buying trends that I know I'm not gonna wear, it's not me, it's not my kind of style, it's not my personal style. Blazers, I'm happy to buy, because I do like to wear blazers on top of my t-shirt when I'm wearing jeans, and if it's a little bit more of like a dressier occasion, right? But dresses, really? Yeah, so I think that's also one of the things, is like buying trends, because as the name suggests, they're trendy, so they will go away eventually, and then what are you going to do with the clothes? I think now that I've learned from my shopping mistakes, I look more into the basics, things that will stand the test of time and that I can continue to use for years and years. And my fifth mistake is not actually shopping my stash. It's not looking at what's already in my wardrobe, because I don't know how many times I've come home from a thrifting expedition to find that I already have in my wardrobe a very similar item. Like, how many blue jeans do I really need? How many blue straight cut jeans and how many blue skinny jeans do I need? How many t-shirts do I need? How many skirts of the same pleated material do I need? I don't really need a lot, and yet I have multiples of them because sometimes I forget I already have these things in my closet, but because I don't bother to look, especially since the changing of the season, I've had a few things that have been put into storage and I forgot that they were into storage. So when I went thrifting for my summer and spring outfits, I come home and then I look at my stuff in the storage and lo and behold, I've got 6 blue denim straight cut jeans. Right, so I think one of the lessons that I've learned is, before, when I feel that urge to go shop and buy something, I need to look at my closet and look at my wardrobe first and see, do I have something already similar to what I saw? Because oftentimes I would see like some of my favorite fashion YouTubers like Emma Hill and Mademoiselle and Audrey Acoin, and they talk about like dressing stylish, and I'm like, oh, I need to have that. I need to buy something like that. And then not realizing that I actually already have something very similar, if not the exact same thing, in my closet. So I end up with doubles and duplicates and multiples of the same thing. So those are my top 5 mistakes when thrifting. Okay, buying because it's cheap, buying because it's a label, not trying on clothes, buying because it's a trend, and not really looking at whether you would be wearing that because it's not the lifestyle that you have, and not shopping my stash. Okay, I hope you guys have learned or gotten something positive out of this video, and if you have, please leave me a comment down below. If you have any other suggestions or comments or your own shopping mistakes, please leave them in the comment section down below so that we can all learn from it together. And I wish you all a very nice day. Bye.